One morning, I poured water into my usual cup. As I lifted it, the water spilled everywhere. Looking closer, I realized the handle had snapped off. Instead of throwing it away, I decided to fix it. I planned to use a heat welding tool to reattach the handle. But when I checked, the welder was broken. With no other option, I set out to build a simple welding device using whatever I had on hand. I found an old battery, peeled off its outer casing, and smoothed the core. The battery core, once polished, could conduct electricity and withstand heat, so I chose it as the welding tip. To secure the core, I used an old motorcycle spark plug. Spark plugs are sturdy, heat resistant, and have threads for tightening. I attached the battery core to the spark plug, making sure it was firmly in place. Next, I took the metal casing from the battery and soaked it in toilet cleaner. This cleaner has a mild acidic property that removes oxidation, improving conductivity and aiding the welding process. After a few hours, the metal casing was shiny again, ready to be used as a catalyst or support material during welding. To power the welding tip, I needed a copper wire. I stripped off the plastic insulation, kept the copper inside, and ran it through a small plastic tube to insulate and protect my hand. One end of the copper wire was connected to the spark plug, the other to a triangle clip, the kind used to connect power in simple circuits. This clip made it easy to attach and detach when needed. Once everything was assembled, I tested my homemade welder. I connected it to a 12V power source. The battery core began to heat up. I tried welding a small piece of metal. The tip heated evenly and melted the thin metal layer, just enough to weld small parts like a cup handle. I took the solution from the soaked battery casing, used a cotton swab to apply it to tiny metal pieces. These pieces served as bridges between the handle and the cup body. After applying the solution, I used the welding tip to attach the metal pieces in place. The process went smoothly. The welds held firm and didn't peel off. Once finished, I let the cup cool for a few minutes, then picked it up. The handle was solid again, ready for everyday use. From a small mishap, I got to experience a fun and creative journey. Building a DIY heat welder not only helped me fix the cup, but also sparked new ideas for repurposing old items and crafting simple tools. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you won't miss more creative tips. Thanks for watching.